Good afternoon, Facebook Land. I am Mandy Horn, the Traveling Compass, and I am a expert travel planner. So what that means is, like, you might have a personal shopper for travel. I am a personal shopper for clothes. I'm a personal travel shopper. I help people design their vacations and all of those good things with expert travel planning and design their trips. So you can find me across all the major social media outlets as the Traveling Compass. And this series of videos is about all-inclusives and how you can have your best experience at an all-inclusive. And today we're talking about how you can not get sick at an all-inclusive. Very, very important. No one wants to get sick on vacation. So let's go ahead and get started as to how you cannot get sick at your all-inclusive. There's two major things that cause illness, you know, other than normal viruses at an all-inclusive or while you're on vacation, and they're mostly food and water related. So the first one we're going to talk about is food. Pull this up here. Okay, so what can you do to avoid getting food sickness at your all-inclusive? So what you want to check for is, one, that your meat is cooked properly. Now, this can happen in the States. It's not just an international thing, especially in buffets or wherever mass food is being produced. It's easy sometimes to have one piece of meat that isn't cooked properly. So when you are eating, what you're looking for, like with chicken, it needs to be fully cooked through. It should no longer be pink, especially if you're having a dark piece of meat around bones, like on thighs or that kind of thing. It should be completely cooked. You should see completely white throughout. It shouldn't have pockets of blood or pink in it. And this is especially true coming off of a grill or other things. You just want it, when you cut into it, that's what you want to see. Fish is a tricky one because this is something a lot of people eat when, of course, you're by the ocean, that you're all inclusive. And so what you want to check for with fish is that when you are cutting into it with your fork, the fish should flake. It should be fully cooked and white. You shouldn't see it being like translucent-y or smooshy in the middle. It should completely flake when you put your fork into it. Now, some fish preparations are naturally raw, like ceviche. They're cooked in acid, and so it doesn't actually have a heat source. And here's some place where you need to be really careful if you're eating fish that isn't cooked on a heat source. You should see that it's been chilled. So, like, if someone's passing around ceviche on a tray, and that didn't just come out of an ice cube next to them, you need to pass. Like, it should be kept chilled until you eat it, or it can, in fact, go bad, which is not good. So fish preparations that are not cooked with a heat source, you need to make sure that you can physically see that they've been chilled, or they should be cold by the time you're eating them. If it's warm when you eat it, that is a bad sign. So no heat source, make sure you're really careful. Your fish also should not smell like chlorine. It shouldn't smell, in fact, overly fishy or any kind of bad odor. So if any of those are taking place, you need to pass on the fish. The second thing for food is that you need to go easy on the fruit. And this may sound kind of funny, because but one of the things that actually causes people to get sick on vacation is that they go to these tropical places with all this wonderful tropical fruit, like mangoes and bananas and oranges and all of those kinds of things. And they overindulge, way more fruit than they would normally eat, and it upsets their stomach, and they end up with diarrhea or stomach cramps or really, really ill. And they think, in fact, that they've had food poisoning, when what really has happened is that they had way more fruit than they would normally have, way too much fiber. So go easy on the tropical fruit, especially in things like fresh fruit juice and smoothies. These often get people. Some fruits, when they are juiced, are super potent laxatives, like pears. So that fresh pear smoothie you had after the spa can have some unintended consequences. So go easy on all forms of fruit, on the juicing, on the smoothies, on the whole fruit, if you are having stomach problems. And then as much as we're talking about food, stay hydrated. The reason this is on a food list is because a lot of the ill effects of jet lag are actually because of a lack of hydration while you're flying. So when you're flying, people tend not to drink. When they're traveling, enough water, and they have digestive problems because of it, you can have one or the other. But typically people get constipated from not drinking enough while they're traveling. Then they get to the resort, they eat a whole ton of fruit, and they drink too much alcohol, and it just amplifies the effects, and they can either get super uncomfortable, constipated, or all of that lets loose because you suddenly start drinking and eating a bunch of fruit and then get really, really sick. And they think it's because they have bad food when in fact their body is just reacting to going through so many different stages of dehydration and then all these different changes. So you just want to take care of yourself. You need to stay hydrated while you're traveling. And once you get there as well, you can feel really, really lousy if you've been out on the sun all day and or have had alcohol to drink and you're extra dehydrated and people can think they got a stomach bug or had bad food when in fact they're just super dehydrated. So make sure you stay hydrated with clean water. So that is how you can avoid foodborne illness while you are at the resort. But let's talk about the other biggie, which is clean water. Now, some places naturally have cleaner water. Jamaica is a big one. Islands like that that have those kinds of things have filtered water at everywhere where it's safe to drink the tap water. Tend not to have this as much. But if you're going to any location in like Mexico, the Dominican Republic, any of the smaller islands where they don't have filtered water, or like Asia, this is a big one, places where the water is not clean. These are, you know, do this and not that to avoid getting sick from the water. So first up on do this is going to be your bottled water. Now, only you need to not drink the tap water, including in the bathroom or brushing your teeth or something. Now, some people open their mouth in the shower. You need to not do that. So what you need to do is drink bottled water only. So, and you need to make sure that you have bottled water with you so you don't get stuck someplace. If at a restaurant they serve you a glass of water, you can ask for bottled water or even sparkling water because you know that will have come from, you know, an actual bottle. I would highly recommend that, even paying for it over the tap water. It's not a good place to save money. Do not drink tap water at restaurants, especially if you are out of the resort. Do not drink tap water water that's given to you unless you physically saw it come out of a bottle. So you need to be having bottled water and you need to have it in your room to brush your teeth with. Next up is you need to use canned beverages and avoid ice cubes. So whenever possible, if you like soda, get a can of soda because you know that that will have been safe versus something where someone has put ice cubes in and poured soda over it. You may not know if those ice cubes were made with clean water. Now, if you're drinking an alcoholic beverage, it helps. It tends to kill off some of what might be in the water and you do a little bit better, but ice cubes can be dicey. Now at the better resorts, they're pretty careful to make their ice with clean water, but if you have a sensitive stomach, I would suggest that you avoid ice cubes and ask for your beverages without ice, to minimize the exposure to unclean water. Then you also need to avoid raw produce and salad, and look for cooked produce and fruit that you can peel. So this surprises a lot of people. Outside of the U.S., most cultures do not naturally have raw vegetables. They are typically fermented or pickled or cooked in some way, or fried, coming off of a hot wok or something else. So most cultures do not eat raw produce. The U.S. does. We eat a lot of salad, and that can be contaminated. It can be washed in tap water as they wash the lettuce, or grown in a contaminated area, fed with water that is contaminated, and then you eat it raw and get sick. Or they'll put the veggies on a tray that has water on it that was like they rinse off a plate and then put the raw vegetables on it, and now you're having the water that's not treated, even though they didn't mean for you to be exposed to it. So raw produce in general, I never honestly eat salad outside of the States, period. I just don't. I have had parasites too many times. So I would suggest that you, which just surprises a lot of people, that it's actually coming off of the salads that they love to eat, where they think they're being healthy. I would avoid salad and any kind of raw produce. But what you can do is indulge in cooked produce. So if it's like like fried or coming hot or stewed or braised vegetables, that is a great choice for your produce, for how to eat your veggies while you're on vacation. Try something local because those typically are cooked vegetables and you'll enjoy them. If you have a really sensitive stomach, the next level that you can take it up to is to only eat fruit that you peel. And this kills people because the fruit is wonderful. Usually if you're in a tropical area, But if you need to be extra cautious because you tend to get sick easily, I would not eat the fruit that they've cut on the buffet where they'll have like all those beautiful tropical fruits. They're all like, you know, in flower shapes and whatever out on your buffet. I won't eat those. I know. Because in fact, after they have peeled them or whatever, they may be putting them on a tray that was rinsed with dirty water. So I will only eat fruit that I peel myself, like bananas, oranges. If I see them cutting a pineapple physically and putting it on my plate, I will do that. But something that I myself peel so that I know that it's clean and hasn't been placed on a contaminated surface. Now that's kind of like extra strict, but if you get sick easily, that is something that you can do to avoid having further problems or continuing problems. So those are my best ways to avoid unclean water on your trip and to have your better food options to make sure that you have a good experience while you're there and so that you don't get sick. If you have any questions about what to expect for food or drink at all-inclusives, go ahead and leave them for me in the comments. I run these to make sure that you guys have the best trips possible and you can travel smart. That's my job. So I'd love to get to chat with you if you have anything else I can help you with. Thanks, guys. I will talk to y'all soon.